Thanks for joining in, folks. Today I'm going to walk you through my Bilstein-based, what I call Frankensuspension. What this is it's not drastically different from what the Spec Miata guys run. I'm using off-the-shelf Bilstein B6, their HD shocks, which is similar to what Spec Miata runs. I'm running threaded collars that simply slide down over the shock body and engage in with the C-clip ring. I'm running a spring set out of Ohlins, front top hats out of Ohlins, stock rear top hats, and we'll get into the details of this setup and why I think it has good performance and some good advantages over something you might just buy off the shelf. All right, so as you can see in this picture, I'm running, again, the Bilstein B6 shocks. I got them off Rock Auto, less than $500 for all four. I haven't moved the circlips. They're not revalved, so they're completely off-the-shelf budget shocks in every way. This threaded tube is from All-Star. I think this is the 5-inch version. I think any version that's longer would be a little bit too long. This is tough to see, but you can kind of see that All-Star machined a square lip inside this tube, and that's what engages the square circlip on the Bilstein shock. But what happened was, is when I inserted the threaded tube in this direction, as I was sliding it down the shock body, it was sticking up too far, and that would actually cause the body of the car to collide with the body of this threaded collar. So what I've done on this opposite side, and this was an unsuccessful version, is I got a big drill bit that you'll see in a second, and actually machined down one of the stepped grooves on the other side, so that way it was also a square shoulder, and that allowed me to reverse this tube to be able to drop the tube further down on the shock body. So this is a 53 millimeter sort of hole saw that I got off of probably Amazon or eBay. The problem was is that these teeth, they were a little bit too big in diameter. And so that's where you see here, I have all of that extra material that was cut off from the body of the threaded tube. That is not ideal. You know, that's how it comes, that's how it looks, and that's how it ended up. But what I was able to do is using a 4.5-inch angle grinder, spinning this on the drill, spinning the angle grinder, I gently grinded down this outside diameter of these teeth here until this drill bit could just barely fit in. As you could see, there's a little bit too much play on that side, but I slowly took off a little bit of the teeth until this barely fits down inside there. It's a tight fit, but not so much that it damages the paint. And that's how I was able to machine this circlip groove to be able to reverse this sleeve. Okay, so that takes care of the shocks and the threaded perches. The next part of the puzzle was the springs. I ended up repurposing off-the-shelf Ohlins springs that actually come on the RX-8 Road and Track kit. These springs are a standard 2.5-inch ID at the front, 8 inches long, and 8K rate at the front. And the rears are a 70 millimeter to 100 millimeter taper spring, also about 8 inches long and 5K rear. So 8K front, 5K rear. That works well with the natural frequencies. I think if you do the math, it's ballpark about 1.9 hertz front and rear. So a fairly flat ride with that concept. The spring rates, they handle well at the track and the autocross. They ride well on the street. I think 8K, 5K is an excellent compromise for a dual purpose car because the ride quality is nice. It has enough roll stiffness, I feel, under racing conditions. And then if you run in the wet, you obviously don't want a very stiff setup in the wet, and you don't want a very stiff setup on bumpy circuits. So because I drive year round on the street, on bumpy circuits, racing the dry, racing the wet, I think it's an excellent overall compromise, and I don't like my cars to be overly stiff and overly non-compliant. You know, I like good suspension movement and good suspension compliance for all of the reasons we just talked through. So that sort of takes care of the springs. The last piece of the puzzle was how to get these springs to interface with these threaded perches and to interface with the top hats. So first, the front OEM Mazda top hats, you would have to do some significant fabrication to make those seat a standard 2.5-inch spring. because again, those are designed for a Mazda taper spring. So instead of reusing the front top hats, I ended up using the Ohlins top hats, again, off of that RX-8 Ohlins Road and Track kit. I think you can source those through Ohlins for maybe $300 for the pair, I think. Hopefully it's not $300 per. But since I had them laying around, it made it pretty easy, since those actually interface with the Bilstein shock. They interface with the spring that I wanted to use. The only difference I had to do was to machine down the spacer that they provided in their kit. I think it ended up being 10 to 12 millimeters in length, but that actually allowed me to get additional front suspension travel, so additional compression travel on the bump stroke. So that actually worked out quite well in terms of suspension travel. So otherwise, the Bilstein shocks, they feed through the top hat, the same nut is used, and haven't had any issues at all with using those sort of spherical mount top hats from Ohlins at the front. At the rear, I wanted to reuse the OEM top hats because they retain really good suspension travel and because they can bolt back into the factory reinforcement locations. I was able to use the factory rubber isolator. The 70 to 100 Ohlins spring mates with that top hat. And this isn't a surprise because the Ohlins Road and Track kit, it actually reuses the factory RX-8 rear top hat. So the only issue is that since the rear springs were 70 millimeter ID, I think that's like 2.75 inches inner diameter, and that was too big and too sloppy for these All-Star threaded perches. So what I did is I went to a vendor on eBay who specializes in Delrin bushing adapters. But I drew up the adapter, the thicknesses, the IDs, ODs, and provided that to the vendor. And, you know, within a few weeks, they had me a set of adapters that fit on the All-Star perch snugly and then take up that additional ID slack on that rear spring so that the rear spring stay centered on that All-Star perch. And as most folks probably know, Delrin, it's a pretty strong, pretty resilient material. And it is load bearing in this application, but I haven't seen any issues in terms of wear or breakage on those Delrin perches. So in terms of how the kit all comes together, I sort of talked through all of the major challenges that were associated with making the Ohlins springs and top hats work in conjunction with the Bilstein off-the-shelf shock. Overall, on the street, even with no changes to the valving, the ride quality is quite reasonable. On the track, the body roll is pretty reasonable. I should add that I'm running the Bilstein off-the-shelf bump stops, and I think that they engage front and rear at a very similar time. So the behavior of the bump stops during cornering is pretty well-tuned and pretty well-matched, I think. So no need to worry, I think, too much about the bump stops. You can use the off-the-shelf Bilstein bump stops. Like I said, the setup feels plenty stiff for track use. I am running the Progress 32 millimeter front sway bar, so that's about the biggest you can get without going like one of the NASCAR style bars. For me, it made a lot of sense because I was essentially repurposing components from an old suspension. And so I've got, you know, off-the-shelf shocks, Ohlins springs and top hats, All-Star sort of circle track car parts, and some custom stuff thrown in. So there you have it. That's essentially why I refer to that as the Frankensuspension. I think it works pretty well. Maybe it'll inspire some folks to try similar setups. For those of you who know Fat Cat Motorsports, it's not so different than what some of the stuff he does, because of course he uses Bilsteins, and then he has to do threaded perches and things to make his custom coilovers, and certainly his are a little bit fancier because he does certainly a lot with the valving on those. But for an off-the-shelf budget solution, this has worked pretty well. So I hope you guys found this to be of interest. Stay tuned for more videos in the future. I'll be at Summit Point Shenandoah for Helmets Off for Heroes here in a couple of weeks. So yep, stay tuned for some more track videos. Yeah.
Hello.